grand finals for them, and it's going on right now. It looks like we just started here. We got Gio, and Momo. It's like G and then Yo.
Oh, it's legit.
Oh, legit. Oh, dang. All right. Let's go legit.
Okay.
Oh, Klaatu. Okay. So, yeah, all right. So we got Klaatu on the Olimar. And I mean, both of these players are going to be, they both got top 64 at Genesis 6. So both very, very skilled players and definitely PR representatives for NorCal.
That's right.
Now they're in grand finals playing for a $500 pot.
That's right. And of course, we see our Olimar player landing that F smash. Klaatu
is definitely the Olimar, and legit is definitely the Diddy. But yeah, I'm just letting everyone know.
All right, so yeah, legit landing that F smash. Wait, legit, right?
Legit's Diddy.
Okay. All right.
We're good.
Chill. All right. Wow. Klaatu, I didn't get to see Klaatu over at Genesis, but it seems to be going very strong against legit.
Yes, Olimar is my personal opinion is I think Olimar is definitely a top three character in the game. He is a zoner that you usually. Oh wait.
He
okay.
went for the hype maker. That was the money maker right there.
The money maker. The give me that 500. And right now we got the white Pikmin ticking away and already 90% on legit. This character does so much damage, and Olimar definitely just one of those zoners that have one of the best tools out of all the zoners when you get up close. Like, I finally got up close to Olimar, and then Olimar's like, yo, I got up smash though.
I got up smash, got down smash, I got so many answers for you trying to get into my face. Like that back air sending you outside into the blast zone and taking game one for Geo.
Yeah, and Klaatu just doing a really solid job closing it out, two stock, and yeah, just he's been maining Olimar since Brawl. See, this is another character that they be cashing out, man.
That's right.
They be cashing out. Like, Olimar was broken in Brawl, so like they had Brawl.
Is that the word you want to use? Broken.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Just want to make sure.
Broken.
Okay. Broken in Brawl. Broken in Brawl.
Smash 4. You know, they changed the Pikmin aerials.
He was definitely a counterpick character.
He was a counterpick character, and Shuton definitely went in with Olimar, but definitely pretty hard to do.
Yes.
Your aerial moves did not. They had item priority, which means like if I used an aerial and you used an aerial, that you would just win. But in this game, they took that out. So now all Olimar's aerials, they're pretty much like sword moves.
Okay, well, Klaatu starting out strong again and legit not able to make it back. Only taking 37%, and then Klaatu just comes in strong.
Yeah, Klaatu definitely went in. And, I mean, most Olimar players are definitely reserved, but Klaatu definitely showing that he is not afraid to go off stage and give you the – I don't want to say hands. I guess give you the Pikmin.
Give you the plants.
he's a vegetarian, man. Oh. All right, so right now he's got the banana controls. Well, oh, Matt, if that purple connected, that might have been the stock.
I don't know. I mean, Diddy is fairly light, but you really think the S smash would have been that strong? Okay, you know what? Maybe you're right.
Hey, he was at like he got hit up to 131 there, so it's definitely a different story. He might have lived, but nonetheless, he definitely would have took in a lot of damage. And the purple Pikmin. So if you guys don't know, the purple Pikmins are the best knockback wise. So if you hit like a forward smash or any of the aerials with the purple Pikmin, it does more knockback. And all the Pikmin have different attributes, so playing this character can be really, really difficult. Oh,
but it gave up his own stock just to get the style points. Was it worth Korean?
Definitely not worth. I was actually like, wow, that was a very impressive. Oh, dang.
Oh, yeah. Well, it was so impressive. And if this was doubles, he might have been able to make that back.
Yeah.
So maybe that's something you say for later on.
I'm very sure that legit wanted to not trade there and just get the hit. So very unfortunate there. Klaatu with another two stock. We might be seeing the Swift 3-0 inkling, though.
Just think about like how fast that game two went. Klaatu was able to take legit's first two stocks within a minute.
Yes.
That means 30 seconds.
With a projectile character.
With a projectile character. It's just how hard he was going in. But now we see the character switch from legit, bringing out Inkling.
Yeah, and I definitely agree with the switch. And, you know, if you want to play Diddy and you think Diddy's good, that's fine by me. But in my personal opinion, I think the character is... I wouldn't say, like, bad. Actually, I think he's bad.
Because I would use that character. That's the word I would use. He's not bad, but he's bad enough.
Yeah. The way I like to put it is there's other characters that does what he does, but better. And
exactly.
Inkling is literally the character that is, like, for sure does what he does, but just a lot better. And definitely out of the archetype, the best character of that archetype.
So that's surprising. I didn't.
Wow, and it's like he's winning now. That's so crazy.
I mean, this might be why he was on winner's side of Grand Finals.
It's like Diddy is like bad or something.
I mean, we can't say that.
I can. Hey, Matt, you know? But I mean, just look at the difference. Like, it's just, he has so much more options, man. And
it's
like,
true. A whole minute's passed and he still has all three of his stocks. but Jab, Rapid Jab's coming out from Legit, just showing that, you know, this is may have been the path that he took to get to winner side of Grand Finals.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, Inkling definitely proving to be a lot better pick. And wow, having, you know, confirms that do like 30 plus damage, like that's really nice. And I know Diddy is.
Oh, dang. What was that?
He traded with a smash attack, I believe. This is the only thing I can think of.
I mean, it looked like he actually used the forward B to throw a Pikmin. It clashed with the roller, and then he had enough time to charge F smash.
Ooh, wow. And the edge guard coming out from Legit, the forward air going to kill. I'll tell you what, if that was Diddy forward air, definitely would not have killed. So very good upgrade here for Legit. And there's the Rapid Jab inking him as well.
I mean, as I've been watching Legit play this game, game three, I should say, he's been showing that he has really good management of his ink. He's done a great job of putting ink, enough ink on Klaatu, just so that it'll actually be a detriment.
Okay, here's the deep edge guard here. Gonna catch the high recovery though. I really like it because he was able to throw out a low hitbox, and oh wow, the anti-air up smash trying to come out. He's just trying to seal this out with a two stock of his own.
Okay, well, attaching a few more Pikmin on, but oh, not gonna be able to get that low gimp using the bloop.
Yep, and that's the great thing about Inkling. It's essentially think about, he like threw out the aerial, then he kind of did a barrel, but it's just quicker anyway, and like just pretty much a character that's better than Diddy in every way, shape, and form.
And it has a witch time?
Yeah, and you got roller dog.
Oh, wow.
It's crazy.
So why would we play Diddy?
I don't know, man. I mean, you know, if you play Diddy, there's nothing wrong with that. If you enjoy playing Diddy, that's cool, but if like in terms of like just the competitive world, I just feel like it's hard for Diddy, and like there might be hidden potential in the character.
That's true. I mean,
but do you want to be the guy that puts in like 50 hours of lab work to see that you might be able to beat people? Like, I'm not trying to work that hard, dog. I know there's really good characters.
I mean, I know Wolf exists, so I'm just gonna, you know.
There you go.
There
you go.
Stuff, but we may have been seeing Diddy come out from Legit just because it was winner's side of Grand Finals. He does have that little bit of extra insurance. Yes, he's in the winner's side. So even if he did drop three games to Klaatu, he would still have an entire another set for him to adjust or switch his character.
Okay, fair enough. I mean, but he still like low-key cares about this set because he didn't just go game three with Diddy.
That's true.
So, I mean, but yeah, he had two games. And you know what? I mean, Legit was a Diddy main in Smash 4. Mm-hmm. So it's just hard in the very beginning of the game to kind of like see who's good and who's not. You got to like kind of experiment, but unfortunate SD from Legit there.
Okay, well.
Legit, oh, wait a minute.
Forcing Klaatu, putting a little bit of ink on him with a rap jab.
Okay, and there's the dash jab. That's a very great option for Inkling. One thing about Inkling, and you can't even see Olimar's face, dude.
Yeah, he's fully inked up. Just put a little bit more on him, just in case.
He is doused in purple ink.
It looks like he got that Power Ranger ooze, too.
Dude,
Okay, it's falling off.
What's the character's name? Ivan Ooze?
Oh, yeah, Ivan Ooze, man. You give him the ooze. He's definitely the Ivan Inkling. Yeah. Or Ivana. That's a female.
Yeah, there you go. Okay, backdoor should do it here. Oh, wait. Not really, though. Really good DI from Klaatu here. The up air, no. Going to get back on the ground, and now Legit has a problem here trying to use the up B to get this edgeguard forward air. Does not connect as well.
But getting a couple of jabs and Klaatu fighting back, but the roller gonna connect, and that's gonna even up the stocks. But Legit has 105% on him. How many options does a purple Pikmin have to take a stock like that percent?
Kind of a lot. Yikes. Yeah.
Kind of a lot.
Yeah, kind of all of them.
Kind of all of them. That's a good one.
I mean, back air is gonna be the stronger of most of them. Back air being the probably like one of the stronger aerials for sure. I know up air is pretty strong, but you got to be like kind of closer up. But yeah, I would think back air is the strongest aerial for Olimar.
Okay, now it's trying to get that little bit extra damage. I like that Klaatu is playing a little bit more of a zoning position in this game four than he has in the previous games. He has the stock, and he's definitely using the mindset of I don't have to approach, so I'm going to force my opponent's approach.
Yep, there's a splat bomb set up, another splat bomb set up. Legit running low on ink here. Mm-hmm. Oh, tries to go for the drop zone fair, not on the ledge with low ink. That's a scary position to be in as Inkling.
Mm-hmm. Landing a back air into a forward air, but able to whistle out of the knockback, taking a stock and then taking the opportunity to reset his ink. Smart stuff from Legit.
Okay, up throw up here, really good damage coming out here for, oh, and the Nair as well. Oh, the purple on shield, and that's, you gotta be really scary. Purple hitting you with like a smash attack on shield, you're taking like half your shield for sure. Oh, wow, and the range grab, ooh, Legit almost getting DI cross up and dying for it.
Mm-hmm, now, Legit just a few, maybe one or two good hits away from getting a bracket reset here in Grand Finals.
Dang, and we have a lot of ink here. Klaatu's got to be really careful not to get hit, and already at 81% from two rapid jabs in a neutral air.
I like the S-Smash. I mean, Klaatu had been choosing to recover next to the ledge, so he had definitely conditioned Legit to think that.
Yep, okay, burn the double jump. Okay, now he has... Oh, wait. Oh, the down air on the retaliation. Where's the double jump? He burns it to throw the Pikmin. Oh, there's the Nair.
Okay, really are we going to see another down air or back air?
Oh, he goes too deep.
He went too deep indeed. Now we see him fishing for these up smashes.
Oh wow, I thought he died.
Yeah,
I thought Legit was done.
I thought Klaatu actually won that trade.
So one thing about the smash attacks, though, all of our smash attacks still have that item priority. So if you throw out a move and he throws out a smash attack, it'll either just clank or you'll just beat out the smash attack.
It has that item priority. That didn't look like it clanked, though. It just went right over the Pikmin.
Yeah, it didn't even look like it hit yet.
Drop-kicked
like,
him right in his
because,
helmet.
Like, Inkling was, like, sideways, I was like, oh, Inkling got hit by that F-smash.
Yeah.
That's what I thought, but it's funny.
Zoom in can be a little hard to tell sometimes.
It's just pretty funny because he was actually just, like, hitting him.
Yeah, gave him the drop kick on his helmet. Cracked it.
So we might see the reverse 3-0 with the Inkling here from Legit. And like I said, Legit a very talented player. And guess what, guys? He just started playing Inkling after Genesis.
Did he really?
Wow, that's so crazy that like he just started playing the character like maybe, what, how long ago was Genesis?
A couple weeks ago.
Wow. Wow, and he's already like...
Winning tournaments. Potentially winning tournaments.
He's like already doing way better than his Diddy Kong was doing. Like absurdly better. Like... Getting two stocks.
Didn't you say he got like top 64 at Genesis though?
With Diddy, yeah.
Oh man. That means he's gonna be a real force to be reckoned with.
With a good character. Yeah, it's crazy how that works, huh?
Well, going to game five of set one of Grand Finals with a potential opportunity to reset if Klaatu is able to overcome the raw power that Legit's Inkling has.
Yeah, and he had a really good lead too.
Yeah, he had
pretty much an entire stock lead last game. But I mean especially like Inkling's comeback potential is so crazy because you land a couple rapid jabs. They're fully inked on the ledge probably. Then you nail a couple ledge traps and they're just taking so much damage or you're able to kill them absurdly early.
Okay, well, Legit's definitely making great use of falling forward air. He's using it in a position where Klaatu is forced to, he's committing to throwing out the Pikmin and then he's just using it to hop over it and punish.
Yeah, and he has this back air that's very safe. He has this forward air that actually kills. And, you know, he's able to pressure Klaatu off stage, and that's a really, really big deal.
That's right. So Legit opting to not give Klaatu the opportunity to reset the bracket.
Okay, up air to kill off the Pikmin here. Klaatu trying to refresh here. Oh, the dash grab just missing its mark. The purple Pikmin from cross stage, not enough.
Wow, and that's insane. We're going to see an up throw?
Yeah.
Yes.
Wow, and that was really good on Klaatu's part. Just going to go right underneath the roller, and that's something, you know, some of these short characters do have an advantage of. Very short, hard to hit. Oh, there's the yellow starter, and dang, he just comboed. And with the yellow up smash, you're able to do both the up smash, or combo up smash into up smash, just because you have the extra hit stun. Oh, no SD, okay.
No, he's still able to make it back. Did get a white Pikmin on him, but it didn't do too much.
Yeah, if you hit it off right away, the scary part is when you get a white Pikmin lashed onto you, and then Olimar gets a hit. And then the whole time Olimar's comboing you, you're like taking that dot damage from the white Pikmin.
I mean, it's very scary, and that white Pikmin can do a lot. But what's the tech chase going to be? Whoa, an F smash. Wake up to F smash.
Yeah, get on my face.
Klaatu, man after my own heart. Yeah. I love those options.
Yeah, and I mean, it's just, those are the kind of options where like, hey man, you're just really going to sit back and try to react to what I do with your shield not up? Like, respect? Could I get some respect on my name, please? F smash. Wake up, F smash. Thank you.
Okay, back air. And wow, Klaatu.
Dang,
taking,
so much damage.
Oh, yes, dealing a lot of damage, even getting a parry, but the F-Smash isn't connected. But an F-Smash will, and Klaatu resets the bracket.
All right, so we'll see how the second set goes. I would assume.
We're going to see any Diddy.
Probably not. I mean, he might. Diddy could probably work.
But do you think we're going to see Diddy? I think in Grand Finals, his Diddy's 0-2.
Yeah, 0-2 plus both of those games were two stocks.
Yes.
Yes. Yes.
So if I was a betting man.
If I was legit, I would definitely not go Diddy. But but I'm not legit.
You're
so
right. You
if he does go Diddy,
legit.
There's nothing wrong with that. If he believes. Oh, and Inkling is
hey,
the pick.
Better Diddy. Nice. Like it.
Inkling's
we're definitely here for to win tournaments.
I mean, they're
we're
playing,
definitely here to try.
They're playing for $500. So some people will, you know, throw away some character pride for that money.
Well, some people would. I don't think legit's
I'm
one of them.
What? I think legit would. Come on, man. Like it's like, okay, I can try to prove it with Diddy or I can, you know, get this young Inkling.
I mean, he definitely switched to Ivana, so.
All right, so here's the Rapid Jab coming out from legit. So we're going in. This is a brand new set. So pretty much Grand Finals, the way it works is there's going to be one person in winners and one person in losers. But legit was the one coming from losers. So now he put Klaatu into losers, and he's got to beat him in another set to take him out of the tournament.
That's right. You can see another up throw and convert into up air.
Ooh,
wow.
That almost killed.
That did almost kill. That's insane.
Okay, up tilt. Oh, the up air was coming. But the down air coming out
from that poor Pikmin got ran over.
Got ran over from the roller.
That Pikmin should call a progressive to start a claim.
Gotta get the claim in, man. Oh, man. The back air from Klaatu going to steal out that first stock. But with the return, legit just coming down with that forward air.
Okay, so evening up the stocks, 0-0%. Klaatu expecting a more defensive play from legit.
Maybe
as he
roll away
with
or dash back.
Exactly. Try to get the grab.
Look at the range on back air. And he like confirmed that into a grab. What a character.
Ooh. Spot dodging that F smash. That F smash, I don't care what percent you are. That purple F smash is scary.
Oh, yeah. Okay, here's a splat bomb. Ooh, ledge jump there. Oh, wow. Trying to hit him with the mix up. Okay, here's the up throw up air. Ooh, the whistle.
Yeah. Smart option from Klaatu. We don't see him utilizing the whistle too often, so it does make it very difficult to tell when he is going to use it. But legit still able to close out that second stock.
Yeah, and right there, I mean, just really great utilization from legit. The edge guarding is coming in really clutch. We're seeing a lot of deep forward airs off stage to steal out his stocks, and that's where Olimar can be really weak. You know, he still has options like whistle, which essentially what it does is it gives him super armor. So he'll still take the damage, but he just won't fly anywhere. And it also rotates his Pikmin lineup one.
Mm-hmm. Big up smash for Klaatu as he's trying to bring back this stock. We see a down air to up air.
Nice. And I like how he was able to do that because he down aired on top of the platform. Mm-hmm. And it popped him right in front of him. So he's just able to run off the platform right into the up air. Very great confirm. Oh,
ooh.
Dang, what?
Trade in parries, okay.
Yeah, that was interesting. Oh, we're going to hold the Rapid Jab, get a bunch more ink and damage here. Get the Splat Bomb set up, down tilt as well.
I like that legit's using the Splat Bomb to actually cover certain options. And since like it's his Splat Bomb, he can just wait and explode inside it and just be perfectly okay.
Yeah. Okay, right now getting the refill on the ink, legit topping off. Okay, ledge jump, not going to get caught by these up airs. Klaatu really trying to get this juggle going on, but the landing backer, the roller, this should be it. The up smash, not going to come out fast enough, but the up air to follow will take this game number one. Going to legit.
Legit looking much stronger here in the second set. Mm-hmm. I mean, there were a couple moments in this game one where he was struggling a little bit, but at the same time, control of the game was a majority of it was in his favor and his control.
Yeah, he is definitely running the pace. And that's a scary thing about Inkling, especially a character like Olimar, where, you know, they mainly pressure horizontally. They either pressure, like, straight in front of them or they can up air above them. But that, like, kind of, like, diagonal 45 degree above you, they don't really pressure too well.
Right.
And that's where Inkling can kind of linger around with these falling back airs. And it's like, oh, sweet, like, I'm using my ridiculously good air drift and I'm chilling out in this area where you can't really hit me, maybe just like with a rising fair, but that's kind of it. But if I land a, you know, falling dare, I get into whatever I want, into the jab, into the dash grab. So it can get really scary for Olimar.
All right, well, let's go into game two of the final set for our two players. Starting off with a good start for legit, putting a little bit of extra ink onto Klaatu.
Ooh, this is going to be so much damage. And that was two rapid jabs, right?
That's two rapid jabs is all you need. Two rapid jabs, roller into up smash. I mean, there's a couple combinations that just puts you at max ink.
Yeah. Oh, and here's another rapid jab just to keep Olimar topped off on ink. I saw it a little bit going away, so I just got the re-up. Oh, there's the roller, but he jumped too high.
Yeah, jumped too high. Didn't put himself in the correct position, but running over all those Pikmin. Oh, those poor Pikmin.
He hit the whole fam, dude. He hit the whole fam.
That's right, but Olimar is a commander of many resources. He has no remorse for his Pikmin. He's just going to pull out more.
Yeah, he's got the Pikmin.
Oh, we got sniped with the bomb.
And I was wondering why Legit threw the bomb so far off stage, and I see now, Legit. I see the plan. The up air and disadvantage, not going to quite take it. Another up air, but Legit still alive. Mm-hmm.
Even after getting hit with the yellow and the red Pikmin, still not enough. I don't think it's going to be enough if he throws out another up air just because of how stale it is now.
Yeah, it's Legit right now racking up a good amount of percent, but Klaatu going to retaliate. Legit trying to stretch out a little bit with that forward air, but Klaatu had the forward smash on deck.
Mm-hmm. Let's be real, the percent that Klaatu's at, it's only a couple up smashes with the yellow Pikmin.
Oh, another splat bomb. Oh, man, he almost got the back throw into the splat bomb. Oh, going high, able to get that forward air.
Oh. But 30%, 36% from a white Pikmin that Klaatu just opted not to get off him.
Oh, the tech chase, here's the jab lock. Goes for the dash attack up air. The purple Pikmin, dude, coming in clutch.
I mean, that is definitely the clutchest purple Pikmin I've seen today.
Oh, man, it's so scary. Oh, there's a spot dodge to avoid the roller.
I wonder if he was able to react to that just because
the Pikmin,
took sacrificial, a hit for him.
Yeah, sacrificial Pikmin, man.
I mean, commander of no remorse. That is definitely Olimar.
Oh, there's the up smash. Legit's trying to find this back air, get some off stage here. The double whistle and the up air will seal out this second stock. Klaatu living to very high percents with Olimar. This character is very light, so the fact that he's living this long is very impressive.
I mean, with the help of two purple Pikmin, he's going to be able to escape death a couple times, but Legit able to land the up air and close out the stock.
Yeah, forcing him high right there, really good stuff. Oh, there's the back. Another very interesting... Like, we've seen that twice now, where he sends out the smash attack and he gets hit, but they both hit each other.
He's already sent out the order, get in there, and the Pikmin obey.
Oh, here's a jab. Okay, but Legit not going to get jab locked there from Klaatu. And pretty much last stock, definitely last stock here. And, I mean, we're at the lower percent, so we'll see who takes the lead here. Dash grab, and he's got him in the corner. Ooh, very nice back here into the up throw up air.
But the whistle's going to come in through for Klaatu.
Oh, it's the white Pikmin.
That white Pikmin did a lot of damage.
Oh, wait a minute.
Purple Pikmin's all he needs, though.
Oh, off the top, and you called it yourself, Z-Fly, the purple Pikmin, the down air. Sending him up, but, hey, you know.
I mean... It did its job. Did its job.
Sometimes your aerials don't send in the same direction, you know? But right now, pretty much 1-1 here. And that game was very much so back and forth.
That's right.
I felt like Klaatu definitely was able to nullify the pressure from Legit. That game, you know, slow him down a little bit. Because the first two socks felt like he was getting a little overwhelmed. And then he was like, you know what? I want to make this play at my pace.
He definitely did a better job of latching Pikmin onto Legit. So he was taking that passive damage and Legit just opting to be the aggressor instead of taking the Pikmin off him, just allowing himself to rack up damage. But then we also saw some sacrificial Pikmin take the hit, take the bullet, get down Mr. President, and then allowing Olimar to punish.
I mean, you know, Pikmin lives matter.
Pikmin lives matter.
Do they do? I don't know if everyone feels that way, though. Probably.
I mean, I don't think Legit feels that way. He's just going in on these Pikmin.
I mean, you got to, dude. You out here in the battlefield, you got to have no remorse.
That's true.
Oh, man, and look at that forward smash. Such range. But right now, what an opener from Legit. And instantly kicking that white Pikmin off. And with the pink brush, going to take that with the forward smash.
That's right. Easy early stock for Legit. Only had 33%. Yeah. When he took that stock.
Oh, man, using up half of his ink there, but not getting too much of a hard punish here. Klaatu trying to find an opening, but the way Legit is pressuring around the shield, he's doing such a good job, not being pretty much safe for the most part.
Okay, dropping right in front of Klaatu.
No fear
from Legit. Another rapid jab, but now he's falling a little bit low on his ink. He's going to need to recharge fairly soon. Yep. He might not even have enough to really commit to a rapid jab.
Yeah, because if you run out of ink during a rapid jab, that's not good.
Yeah, you just kind of like shoot nothing. But, okay, he did take that opportunity. Instead of trying to set up a trap, he just took the opportunity to refill his ink gauge.
Okay, no double jump here on Klaatu. Are we going to see the down air, the back air? Good tech. Oh, wait a minute.
He's not done yet. Oh, the down air does not connect for legit.
Yeah, very, very close, but no fuzzy dice here. Oh, but there's the roller. There should be the stock, and the up smash will seal it out. Legit's 3-1 here against Klaatu in Grand Finals.
That's right. Huge lead for Legit. Klaatu still, of course, going to throw him up. Not enough.
That pummel's so funny, dude. Like, Olimar's literally just, like, punching you in the face, dude. Like, dang, man. Oh, there's a splat bomb almost connecting here. Oh, and Rapid Jab by the ledge. But the White Pikmin is ticking away. Legit going to get that off of him. I guess at this percent, it kind of doesn't matter. He's already
That's what I was going to say. Like, the White Pikmin at these higher percents, not exactly as important because you've already in that death percent range.
Oh, man. Are we going to see a 3-stock?
Not like this legit. Not like this legit.
The 3-stock?
Okay, forward air.
Yo, he wants that 3-stock.
He does. He might get it right now. Oh, he tried to give him the boop.
Oh, the forward smash, but he gets grabbed. Okay, this is it.
It's not it!
Okay.
That wasn't a blue pick.
Oh, he's going to get the 3-stock! He's going to get the 3-stock legit with the 3-stock game 2. Wait. Yeah, game 2.
Game 2.
Game
3.
This is game 3,
right? One.
Right.
But
so
now it's 2-1.
Now it's 2-1. Okay, I was like, wait a minute. But yeah, so the score is 2-1 in Legit's favor. And wow, that's crazy.
That is, in fact, crazy. Like what? Like actually, for game 3 of second set
I'm not
set
even like trying
finals.
To diss Diddy anymore. Like, that's just crazy.
Oh, you were talking about Legit's performance. I just meant the fact that like the 3-stock comes out at this point of the grand finals. Yeah. Usually if we're going to see a 3-stock, it's going to be like towards the beginning while either someone's trying to warm up or someone's trying to adjust.
Yeah, right in the middle of the set.
Like exactly, middle of the set.
Was all 3 of the stocks roller kills? I believe they were.
I think only 2 of them were.
2? Okay.
2 definitely were.
2 for sure, and then probably 1 like edgeguard. All right, nonetheless, we're going to be back on Pokemon Stadium 2. Now, as Klaatu, you can definitely bring this to a game number 5. You just got to reset, you know. You got bopped. It's all right.
It happened.
It happens.
Accept it.
Except to Z-Fly. Z-Fly never has gotten 3-stock.
Yep. And I don't plan to.
Dang.
Ever.
That's a pretty legit on your resume, though. Has never been 3-stock.
Yeah, my next...
Like, Klaatu just got 3-stock. He got top 64 at Genesis. My man just got 3-stocked on stream.
In front of a lot of people.
Yeah.
That's tough, bro.
Dang, you're a savage, dude. You're straight up a savage.
Okay, right, great trap.
All right, wait. Oh, okay. I like the pressure here coming out from both players. And again, you know, legit just seems to have Klaatu always in some kind of pressure situation right here. Okay, up throw, gonna wait. Okay, yes, he gets the double jump. What's the landing? Okay, no whistle coming out from Klaatu. Just gonna go straight to the platform. I like the mix up.
Okay, now we see more splat bombs coming out from Legit. Legit definitely slowing down this game as he has the percent lead. And especially with 2 purple Pikmin, you really wanna be careful. Yeah, oh, he's got the kill set up.
Yeah, there's the forward air. Not going to be quite it. But you see how much easier it is for Legit to maneuver around all these Pikmin being thrown and spaced out at him with this air mobility that Inkling does have.
Wow, what a trap.
Yes.
Throwing down the splat bomb, making it so that if Klaatu did, in fact, recover low, he was going to have the bomb to cover his approach, and then using the back air on top of that.
And if it's too strong, you can't tech it. And that was a situation where Klaatu couldn't tech. And like you said, a beautiful trap setup from Legit. And that's the one thing that's great about Inkling. You do have those setup plays that you would with the banana, but it just feels more impactful because the splat bomb just, I feel like since it's like a setup explosion, you can do a lot more with it.
That's right. It definitely feels like more of a threat than the banana would be. And of course, you can use it off stage as well. Back air into grab, up throw, forward air.
Woo, and now he's off stage. Potential second stock could be lost here, but the down air retaliation from Klaatu. But here's the roller. This should be the second stock. And are we going to see a back-to-back 3-stock Z-Fly?
I don't believe it. I feel like Klaatu's going to come out clutch, and there it is. Up smash with a purple Pikmin.
Right, dang, you got
making sure it does not happen again. He's trying to be like Z-Fly.
Oh, dang. you got it. All right. I see you, Z-Fly. All right. So here's the rapid jab, but I mean, okay, you're not getting 3-stock, but can Klaatu take the game?
That's true. I mean, not getting 3-stock is definitely one thing, but you want to keep yourself in the tournament.
I think he wants that 500.
That's right. These two are playing for $500, and right now it looks like kind of in Legit's favor. He's keeping the ink on Klaatu. He's jumping around, making it very difficult to get hit.
Oh, if that roller connected while he was on the ground, that would have been it. He gets the double jump. He's going to catch the landing. Almost gets the landing, but Klaatu was able to reset to the ledge here.
Okay, jumping over, and both these players whiffing in front of each other.
No tech.
Oh, what? He didn't do the second hit.
Oh, you have no
He's
ink, bro.
Out of ink.
You have no ink. Yo, hey, you can't roast him too hard. He just picked up the character at Genesis, man. Come
okay,
on.
Okay.
He's only been playing Inkling for 2 weeks.
All right. But up throw, trying to fish for the up air, doesn't find it.
Okay, trying to pressure here. The forward air will take it legit. Will win Grand Finals 3-1.
That's right. Wow, what a turn of events. Starting out with the Diddy, didn't quite work out. And